This conference will now be recorded.
Hello friends, let us go ahead with CRT test 25. In this we are discussing average speed, boats and stream. In quant versus elasticity between average speed boats and ships, which is a part of time. We go here, water. So the time taken to row up is nothing but upstream, is nothing but twice time taken to go for downstream. And here the distance is same actually. When distance is same, speed is inversely proportional to time. Here upstream is twice downstream, okay, in terms of timing. Then in terms of speed, speed of downstream is nothing but twice speed of upstream. Okay, upstream means again is the stream, maybe again is the wind flow you are moving. Along with the stream means nothing but you are made downstream along with the stream, along okay, along with the wind. Okay, upstream means again is the wind you are traveling. Downstream is along with the wind you are traveling. You are going down, your speed will be more. When you go up, your speed will be less. That's a basic point, right? So here they given about downstream and upstream. Okay, so here distance is same, but then time, speed is inversely proportional to time. Time taken for upstream is twice time taken for downstream, then speed is twice for this. Now here, downstream is nothing but speed of boat plus speed of stream, speed of water flow. When you're going down, it's like going along with the wind. When you're going along with the wind, so speed of boat plus speed of water flow, both will be added along with the water flow you're going. Upstream means again is the water flow. So speed of boat minus speed of water flow you have to do. Now from this, what is the link here is, speed of boat is equal to thrice speed of stream. Remember, whenever you got downstream is twice upstream speed, definitely speed of boat equal to thrice speed of stream. If this is thrice here, suppose, for example, when speed of downstream is thrice speed of upstream, then definitely speed of boat equal to four times speed of stream. If this is three, here we'll get four. Remember that. Now here, speed of boat is thrice speed of stream, speed of current. Okay, current, the rate of current, rate of stream, all this. The given speed of boat is six. We have to calculate speed of stream. Nothing but 2 km per hour. Because the given this is six. Okay, speed of boat is nothing but 6. Take one. That is equal to thrice speed of stream. So once you calculate, we got speed of stream or speed of water flow is nothing but 2 km per hour. Now here, Mittu travels upstream going up. Okay, this at a speed of 8 km per hour and returns the same place by rowing downstream at a speed of 14 km per hour. So speed of upstream is nothing but 8 km per hour. Speed of downstream is nothing but 14 km per hour. Just now we discussed upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of water flow. You are going against the water flow. Downstream means along with the water flow. So speed of boat plus speed of water flow. Now grasping speed of stream. Now consider this is equation one. Consider this is equation two. If we do equation 2 minus equation 1, 14 minus 8 will get 6 km per hour. Here SB, SB cancelled, nothing but this is 2SS. Speed of stream or speed of water flow or speed of current, rate of current, all this is nothing but 3 km per hour. Right? So upstream means again is the stream or again is the wind you are traveling, so your speed will reduce. Downstream means along with the wind. Or along with the water flow, the boat is traveling, so speed will increase. Okay, that's why SB plus SS for downstream, upstream SB minus SS. Now it takes 5 hours to sail from a point A to an island and return. So you have to move from point A to some island and you are returning back. So the time taken to do this entire process is nothing but 5 hours total time taken to move from A to I. Time taken to move from A to I, point A to island and island to point A is nothing but 5 hours. Now one very important point is, so we are going to some place and returning. One you should consider as downstream. When you are going A to A, it is downstream, return must be upstream. This is what you have to assume. They don't mention the question in general. When you are moving from point A to point A, if it is downstream, reverse must be upstream. Reverse must be upstream. Right now, here distance is same D, but downstream means speed of boat plus speed of stream. The same distance you have to travel, but upstream means speed of boat minus speed of stream you have to consider. Now, this is 5, okay. D we don't know, but speeds, this is 16 kilometer per hour speed of boat. Speed of boat are given 16 kilometer per hour. Speed of stream is 8 kilometer per hour. Now here this is by 24, whereas this is D by 8 kilometer per hour. Now one equation, we have one unknown, we have to calculate that. So now here 5 is equal to D into LCM is 24, so we'll get 1 plus 3. This is 4, this is 6 times. So now if you calculate, distance is nothing but 30 kilometers. So distance from point A to island is nothing but 30 kilometers. So this question is all about, this topic, boats and streams. Boats and streams is all about time is distance by speed. Your speed may be upstream or downstream. Downstream means along with the stream, your speed will be more along with the water flow. Upstream is again is the water flow, your speed will be less. That's it. Now downstream, okay, so what is speed of downstream is distance you are traveling 32 kilometers, 6 hours to cover that. 32 kilometers you are traveling in 6 hours. So it's nothing but I can say 16 by 3 kilometer per hour downstream. Whereas upstream is again is the stream. You are traveling 14 kilometers, again 6 hours. So speed is distance by time, 14 kilometers in 6 hours. I can call this as 7 by 3 kilometer per hour. So we already know speed of downstream is nothing but speed of boat plus speed of stream. Whereas upstream is nothing but speed of boat minus speed of stream. So consider this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So question is velocity of the current, nothing but speed of the stream. So if you do equation 1 minus equation 2, you will get 2 times speed of stream is equal to 16 by 3 minus 7 by 3 kilometer per hour, right? Now this is 9 by 3, nothing but 3 kilometer per hour. So speed of stream is nothing but 1.5 kilometer per hour. So speed of stream is nothing but 1.5 kilometer per hour. Speed of current, velocity of current, rate of current, rate of stream, all these are similar. Now a boat takes 4 hours for traveling downstream from point A to point B and coming back. It's pretty much similar to the question what we discussed already. Are moving to A to B, other one is B to A. One we should consider downstream. So we have speed of boat plus speed of stream. Speed of boat is 4, speed of stream is this. So 6 kilometer per hour, adding those two. Other must be upstream. Here speed of boat minus speed of stream, you have to subtract. This is nothing but 2 kilometer per hour. Total time taken to perform this total time taken. So here total time is time taken to move from A to B plus time taken to move from B to A. Okay, this is 4 hours. A to B distance we don't know, but speed is 6. B to A distance we don't know, but speed is 2. Now again, you can take B common. This is again LCM 6. This is 1 plus 3 and you have 4. This 4 cancel. Distance is nothing but 6 kilometers. Distance between point A to B is nothing but 6 kilometers. Now average speed, see here you are moving from A to B with 20 kilometer per hour, and while return you are traveling with a speed of 30 kilometer per hour. See here, both distance, A to B distance and B to A distance, as both are equal. Now when distance is equal, when they're given two speeds, you can use average speed is equal to 2xy by x plus y. Here 2 into 20 into 30, by 20 plus 30 nothing but 50. If we cancel that, we'll get extra 2 because it's like 100. Okay, or else you can cancel step by step. So they're given 2 into x into y. 2 into 20 into 30 divided by 50. So 1010 get cancelled. Now 5 ones, 5 fours. This is nothing but 36 kilometer per hour. 36 kilometer per hour. So average speed is not like sum of the speeds divided by number of speeds is wrong. See, actually this is using formula, but you can avoid the formula approach, considering average speed is basically defined as total distance by total time. Total distance by total time. Here consider the distance for easy as LCM of 20 and 30. What are the speeds they given? Take LCM for that. LCM for 20 and 30 is equal to 60. So I'll consider my distance is 60 kilometers. Here I have to travel from A to B, then B to A. So I'm assuming some the distance is nothing but 30 kilometers. A to B, 60 kilometers. So A to B is 60, B to A is 60. Now, total distance, you are moving from A to B 60 kilometers, B to A 60 kilometers. What is the time? If you're traveling with 20 kilometer per hour, the 60 kilometers with 20 kilometer per hour definitely require 3 hours. Because 20 kilometer per hour means 1 hour you can travel 20 kilometers. But if you want to travel 60 kilometers, you require 3 hours. Whereas same 60 kilometers you can travel in 30 kilometer per hour, 1 hour 30 kilometers, 2 hours 60. So in 2 hours your job will be done. Now this is actually 120 by 5, 24 kilometer per hour. Here also we have a calculation mistake. 2 into 4, 8 into 3 is 24. So 24 kilometer per hour is the average speed when your speeds are 20 and 30. Right. So just now we discussed average speed is total distance by total time. What is the total distance here? First 100 kilometers, then 320 kilometers. 100 kilometers plus 320 kilometers is the total distance. What is the total time? 100 kilometers, you are traveling 50 kilometer per hour. Clearly indicates you require 2 hours time. So 2 hours. 320 kilometers, you are traveling with 80 kilometer per hour. 1 hour 80 kilometers, if you want to travel 320 kilometers, you require 4 hours obviously. So total time is this. So 420 by 6 will get 70 kilometer per hour is the average speed. 70 kilometer per hour is the average speed for this. total distance by total conducted. Nothing more we require in average speed. Now here again, average speed you have to calculate. They're given three journeys. So first one D, second one D, third one D, because three equal. Three parts, three equal parts. Okay, so first one you are going with a speed of 80 km per hour. Second one is 60 km per hour. Third one is 30 km per hour. So if you feel to consider D as a difficult one, what I said, you can take LCM for this 80, 60 and 30 given speeds, which is nothing but 240. I can consider this as 240 kilometers. For the speeds, I'll take LCM. I'll consider that as a 240 kilometers distance. Get three equal parts, right? So first one 240, second one 240, third one 240. You can consider any value for better calculation. We're considering LCM for the given speeds. Now, average speed is, just now we discussed total distance by total time, right? What's the total distance? 240, 240, 240. We have 720 is the total distance, total timing. Now 240 kilometers with 80 kilometer per hour, 240 kilometers with 80 kilometer per hour clearly require 3 hours. 240 kilometers with 60 kilometer per hour time required is 4 hours, whereas 240 kilometers with 30 kilometer per hour definitely require 8 hours. So what is the total timing? 3 plus 4 plus 8, numerator is 720 divided by 15 we have to perform, because total timing is 15 hours. This is nothing but 48 kilometers per hour. See, don't do sum of speeds divided by number of speeds. That's wrong approach. Average speed is always total distance by total time. Now here, A to B 2 hours time, 40 kilometers. B to C 60 kilometers, 3 hours time. What is average speed? Just now we discussed total distance by total time. What is the total distance? 40 plus 60, 100 kilometers. Total timing is 2 plus 3, 5 hours. So we'll get 20 kilometers per hour. So average speed is always total distance by total time. Your total distance is 100 kilometers, total time is 5 hours. Now here, 1 by 4th of the distance, we traveled with the speed of 10 kilometer per hour and remaining distance was 30 kilometer per hour. Now total distance, 1/4 of the distance he traveled with 10 kilometer per hour, remaining distance means 3/4 of the distance with 30 kilometer per hour. Okay, now average speed is total distance by total time. Total distance by total time. What's the total distance? First 1/4 of the distance, the remaining is 3/4 of the distance. So we consider total distance is D. What about this now? Time, time is distance by speed. Time is distance by speed. Now here 1/4 of the distance is traveling with a speed of 10 km per hour. Then 3/4 of the distance is traveling with a speed of 30 km per hour. Numerator is D. Denominator, it's actually D/40 plus D/40, because 3 once 3 tens, D/40 plus D/40. So anyhow, this is nothing but D/2D/40. Okay, DD get cancelled, we'll get 20 kilometer per hour. So average speed is 20 kilometer per hour. Forty by 2 will get, so which is 20 kilometer per hour. Right? I hope you understand this average speed boats and streams. Average speed is total distance by total time. In boats and streams, again, time is distance by speed values. That speed is equal to distance by time. But important point in boats and streams is upstream and downstream. That's it. Now here, all cars are cats, all fans are cats. Conclusion. Conclusion means which is definitely true, or which is common in all the results, which is common in all the results, are definitely true, we can say. Right now, all cars are cats. Okay, next they given all fans are cats. So here all fans are cats. This is one possible case. Or all cars are cats. This is cars. This is cats. All fans are cats.
This conference will now be recorded.
So this is one possible case, and second possible case is this. So here you can see that all cars are cats, all fans are cats. These are also possible. Our third possibility is, so maybe this is also possible actually if you check. So this is cars, whereas this is fans, this is cats. Still the statements, all cars are cats, yes, all cars are inside the cats. All fans are cats, yes, still all fans are cats. But problem is, these three diagrams are correct for the given statement, but what is our conclusion, which is always true? Is all cars are fans true in all the statements? No, it's only correct in third possible case. Third one, it's not correct in all. It's not correct in all. Some fans are cars also, it's correct in only second one, or maybe here also first one, it's not possible. So neither conclusion one nor conclusion two. Conclusion is which is definitely